Hello, myself Rugby Gamre. Today I'm going to give an introduction on the means of production of the meaning. So collaborating everything, there are five objects which are used in the education, which part by part we will discuss it. And the things which are going to change, as of we know today, we get so many things like e-classes, e-texts, then e-books, and many of that things which are involved today, but not they were not before. So, and the things we are going to discuss is that which of the types and which of the things would get changed and which might be changing right now in the system of education and the system of learning. As I said, there are five main objects which are used in the education. The very first is the means of production of the meaning. The second are the different types of form of the classrooms. The third is the social relations between the text and the learning. The fourth is the text of the classroom. And the fifth is the assessment of learning. So, if we talk about the assessment, if we talk about the text, the forms, these things might get changed or they are changing currently as we have the evolution. The same thing is happening with the studying and the learning system too. So, we are going to start with the very first object, which is the means of production and their meaning. So, traditionally what happened is, a kid used to go in a school at the very first moment and he used to draw a simple random stuff. He didn't knew anything what he's about to draw, but he just mug up the pencil. He just makes any circles or squares. But we all know that the main motto was to learn alphabets, to learn the numbers, to write the stuff, to read the books. And during that time, the essential tool was for the students were only the pen, pencil and the paper. Finally, a student used to give an exam at the end of the semester and he used to have a problem. And what happens today is the students are exposed to thinking. They can think whatever their mind wants to. And they can these things are applied in the multi-modern forms and multi-modern writings. As we need words to explain things, we need words to explain the diagrams, the mapping, and we need to, and so this is the new way of the textual object. So the multi-modern writing is a dynamic place and you don't have to use other apps to open that. And it can be shared with your parents, it can be archived and it can be exposed to the other classes and it can be shared with other classes. So the main thing is it allows a student to produce information by its own self. The second transformation or a second object is the form of classroom discourse. So what actually happens in the class? A teacher picks a student, he asks him the question, the student responds, and then the teacher evaluates. For an example, a teacher will evaluate a question and he'll pick up a student. He'll ask, what is the furthest planet from the sun? And the students respond, it's Pluto. And then the teacher evaluates that this is right. So what happens here is, it is like a game. A student is concerned about what is going inside a teacher's head and about guessing that what question would be asked. In a multi-modern learning, there are different type of time and a spice expect. Spice expect is something that in a class, your practical knowledge and the studying system would be taken in the same class and the time expect will be that it would be happening in the same time. So there is a very classical relationship between the teachers and the students. So in the world of education, we don't need friends, we don't need followers. This is called as a worst metaphor. So in multi-modern writing, your assessments, your tests and your lectures, you can just upload it on YouTube, on Drive or on any of the social media sites in which you can communicate with your teacher. And there itself, you'll be given the marks, your assessment reports. And so this all comes under the multi-modern learning. So next, I am going to tell about the advantages of the classroom discourse. So the first one, it is highly engaging. The second is everyone responds. And there are the both of the systems like the oral and the written. And when everyone responds, there is a learning difference and it is visible and valuable. The reading and writing and the participation is mixed about the right. We can break out of the four walls of the classroom and the cell of the timetable. And the new transparency has been created. Classroom discourse actually means by the language which is shared among the teachers and the students to communicate in the classroom. As we know that talking or a conversation is the medium through which the most of the teaching takes place, and so to studying the classroom discourse, the study process is kind of a face-to-face conversation or a face-to-face classroom teaching. So if we talk about the advantages, so the very first thing I have noted is that every students respond. If we talk about any specific website or a website created by a teacher, there is a small chat box, and in that chat box, many students can communicate with the teacher. They can ask their doubts, and if the teacher asks difference, so there we can learn different things from each of the students. As we know, everyone has the knowledge, and everyone can give the specific answers, and we can see the difference, and it is visible, and from that we can learn many different things. This learning is highly engaging, in sense everyone is very interested to know about the answers, and also this learning makes the teaching process very interesting, and also we can break many walls, like in the classroom or in the cells of the timetable. Also, anyone can become an initiator. So the role of a teacher in a classroom is to control the classroom and the students' behavior. In addition to this, listening should be the most important thing, and giving attention to them is very important in order to maintain an interest in the subject.
Hello sir, my name is Aniket Badal Singh Rajput. I am from second group, subgroup first. As my friend Rugby explained the feedback of the learning of the study, my topic is social learning, collaboration and intelligence. Nowadays we are very connective with the network problem, network facing any session. We just studying the learning distance learning from the pandemic situation now we are facing. So now in that situation, we are just going on with the flow of river. As the knowledge that are flow, which are taken from the internative mode, in the intelligence session, the scholar projects start writing their session and texting in the social media. We just taking information from in writing using the embedded and the public view from that point of view. And where the writer get the feedback using the public point of view, public self-review using feedback on the public issues, that there are two types. Firstly, I'm just going to explain the cognitive form of learning. There are the learning activity, a focus on the representation of a specific content knowledge, and the disciplinary practice, thinking about a specific topic. It's a fact and argument. In which fact some scientists or some workers, some teachers do their text or their work on the internet programming section, and those people they are not interested, and they have some problem with that. They get in a argument on the from section of point view or review section. And the third is empirical work, outlined a specific content, applying disciplinary resourcing to that content. And the fourth one is the individual intelligence, the activity of representing knowledge. And the fifth one is the learning, the knowledge representative made by the student. When the scholar student from the each and every classroom do their works in the form of cognitive map, or in the form of text, in the form of notes, they just upload it on the site, that in which helps to another student from taking information from that. We just take the basic format of the study and learning, so we get the knowledge. So as we pass exam, we are medical student, we get nowadays we get the information from the texting, from the lots of apps we are using now, and we just get information from that. As we doesn't need to have books today, we just have the point of forms of the book in the PDF form, and we just take information from as we have. Sir, next form of the cognitive is a metacognitive. It also has some subtypes in which the self-regulation of learning. It includes the project objective, phase outline, ongoing dialoguing around the processes. and the second one discipline thinking, a focus on the general conditions of insightful work. In this discipline, entomological reflections are made. And the third one is theoretical work, thinking based on the general theoretical perspective of the discipline. And the fifth one is a collaborative intelligence, the structures, feedback, production, diversity in learning from variety perspective. And fifth one for assignment. Assignment is a formative assignment by the peers teaching and self retrospective data analyzing. We also conducting such format nowadays for submission of work. That's the last time we just for the submitted as we have cognitive map. It's also the one of the form of the assignment. So those session are involved in the social learning, collaboration and intelligence. From the social learning, so we get the lots of information from the world in every place that we are here. We doesn't need to go to that world, to that place, that the information are relatively happen, that the situation are relatively happen. We get all information in the point of reception in the one word form. So this is the format. Now this is the section that are conducted in the social learning, collaboration and intelligence. And the fourth section I'm just going to discuss, I'm just going to tell about the text of the classroom. The text of the classroom is a discovered by the format of the book that are written form. But nowadays the books are uploaded on the social media, or the books are getting printed or get in the pen drive form. So the first book, this is written in the Lynn Dalton Bomber. Lynn Dalton, the first book is written in the word processor. But so in India we also have Nalanda. It is a world classroom. It includes the millions of books, millions of knowledge and thinking. From the any section in the corner of each and every point, the student came here and took the lots of information from the any section. That's a medical section, engineering, pharmacology, path philosophy, and plant section, pharmacology, etc. And it also have a writing format of the book. The book writing format include the index, diagram also include the labeling, highlighting and point section. In the classroom we discuss about any topic in any section in any field, but we get all information in one room when we start learning from the text. It has the format of petrotyping and feasibility questions. Learning as a knowledge procedure, changing the balance of agency productive diversity. In that section, the format of the book that is uploaded on the internet are the diagrams are the right hand side, the index on the right hand side, the labeling and the point theoretical section on the left hand side. We also have the test, we also have the MCQ question in that section. As we conducted this type of method, this type of points nowadays, we just pass the test from here. So this is the point section. I'm just text from the text of the classroom. If I take a mistake, so sorry for that. Thank you so much, sir.
Hello friends, I'm Shishir Chaudhary. I'm from subgroup 1 and group 2. So my topic is transformation, assessment of learning and literacy. So what we are having in our system is like we keep on learning for the whole year in our school, college, university. For a whole day we keep on whole semester we keep on learning and cramming up all the knowledges, and we are provided with one single day for a one single subject or two subjects a day. Like we got a fixed span of time in which we have to prove ourselves, like how intelligent we are. In that only fixed span of time, in that fixed pattern of paper, we have to prove ourselves, our worth, our intelligence. In that we were provided with a pattern of paper in which we have to write essays, like wrong answers. We have to brief the questions on our last term of memorizing power. And that's the only thing that which decides us, which gives us the marks, and which tells us that how capable we all are. And this is all the old standard system. This should be done with the future students. And these are not the basic things that should be done to the future students. Standard model is like you are provided with a formula, or you just learn the formula and you just have to find the answer. You just have to find the answer on that formula. It's like you are having an option A, B, C, D in your question paper, and you have to just tick the one answer. It's like by luck you have marked it the right answer, or by unfortunately you have marked the wrong answer. It doesn't matter now. Like if it's something you have learned, you remember after the paper. It doesn't matter now. So it should be changed. Standard model having two main perspective that should be changed is like selected response assessment and supply response assessment. These two things should be changed. The limitations of the standard model: long-term memory, process learning and false positivities, and strange artifacts, limiting sampling based on the highly mediated interference, disturbing experiences, linear, isolating individuals, and retrospective judgments, and the instance of inequality. What we are doing in standard model, like we are dividing the students on the basis of grades, like you got A plus, you are super genius. Like you are super genius in cramming, man. Actually, it feels like you are super genius in cramming. You are good learner. You are not a good what to say, you're not a good student. You are just a good learner. You are a good student, but you are a learner. On the basis of learning, you are a good student. So you are dividing a student on the basis of say grades, on the basis of grades. So it's you are focusing on inequality, but you are emphasizing on equality. Bro, this is not the thing. This is not the thing. This is not the system. This is not the system on which we should emphasizing on. We should create some tasks, or should create some say surveys to conduct and to get students together. And you know, if you got B plus, like you are an average man. Like you are not so good, you are not so bad, you are so-so. Like 50-50, you are 50% bad and 50% good. That's all about you. That's all about. It will be written in your report card, or you'll get this whole semester cramming power in that report card. That yes, you are a B plus person. You can, if you will, you can achieve, or if you won't, then you can't achieve something in your life. This system, this standard model system, teaches us, or say emphasize on us. So coming to the next part, astro plots. Astro plot is basically divided into three parts. The first is knowledge phase, second is focus phase, and the third is helping phase. Like the first, we all know that yeah, knowledge is a basic thing to participate in something. But yeah, the focus is a very most prominent thing that you should require in your hand. And the third thing is that help phase, help sector. Help sector is basically like you are participating or collaborating with your colleagues, with your friends, with your mates. So like you know, helping and supporting and collaborating is the best way of learning. Like you can learn very well when you are collaborating with your mates. This new method is teaches us like yeah, you are a human, you are having some values. This new method teaches us like yes, you should respect your colleagues. It should maintain dignity, and in the process you all learn this process, dignity, maintenance of each other's respect. That's all you will learn from this. And like sharing, I told early, like sharing information is like, when you share information or build information together, it will be like creating more ex it will be cre creating like more experiences, or say more permanent knowledge for you. Like you will remember this for a whole life. So it is said that like there is no necessity of embedding assessment. It is already embedded everywhere in your in your learning process if you collaborate with each other and just focus and gain a little bit of knowledge. That's it. That's